Hello there, this is Roberto Matthews with another tutorial for you. Before we begin, I'd like to say thank you so very, very much. We've accomplished 5,000 subscribers. And of course, every time I hit the 1,000 mark, I do what I normally do and give you some free code. So today's tutorial will show you how that code works. And at the end of the tutorial and in the description below, you can just go ahead and download the full code to how I did this and apply it to your project. So today what we're going to do is this little gallery here. And as you can see what it says here, click to expand photo. When you click on any of the photos, you can see that it expands, allowing the other pictures to kind of go away. And then when you click on it again, all the pictures come back. And the reason I wanted to do it this way is because if you don't want to use a modal, if you want to make it really quick and dirty, it's a really easy way to create your own galleries. So let's get right to it. So let's start with the HTML. The HTML is quite simple. All I did here was bring in some unsplash photos, and I brought them in at high quality, 1200 by 1200, just so that when I expand on it, it will come out as nice high quality. But that's really up to you how you want to do it. Of course, we put all of these images inside another div. And here I have click to expand photo. Now, in the CSS, we just have some regular formatting CSS. We put a little padding around the body just to kind of give it some depth here. This is not necessary. This is just because when I had all that filler information, I needed to format that, so that's not necessary. But here is what we need. The image gallery is going to be a flex, which is what's going to give this nice 3x3. Of course, it could be 4x4, it could be 5. What I did was I made them 30%, so it could be 3x3. But of course, you can put it, if you want it 4x4, you can do 20 or 25%. Oh, a little smaller. Let's try 20%. There we go. And so now we have a 4x4. So it really doesn't matter. I'm going to do 3x3 just because that's easily divisible by the 9 that I have here. But of course, you can set it up any kind of way you want. I have flex wrap because otherwise the flex would make it go all in one line. And of course, your justify and your alignment. And then this width of 95% just gives it this gallery, gives this entire gallery a way to be responsive. And so here's a responsive gallery, which is what I like. Of course, we give it a max width. You can do anything you want, but I gave it a max width. That way it doesn't become too large. Okay. To each image, we give it a width of 30% so that it could fit 3x3. We give the cursor a pointer so that the people know to be able to click on them. Another little visual cue, I gave it a filter of grayscale of 75% grayscale. That way, when I hover over each image, it'll become a grayscale of 0, which means there's no grayscale. And that way, it kind of visually represents. But that's really up to you. You can use a border. You can do whatever you'd like. But that's how I'm doing it this way. So now we're going to go ahead and create our user interface here. And the way we're going to do it is very simple. What we're going to do is we're going to create the grow class. And we're going to create the shrink class. So basically, when you click on one of these, it's going to grow to 100%, and then it's going to cause the other ones to shrink to 0% and then display none. Okay. So I'm going to show you why we say display none in a second, because even though it shrinks, well, I'll show you. Better to show you than to explain. So let's go ahead and create the grow. So like we said, we're going to just do a width of 100%. That's really all we need. Let's go ahead and give one of these the grow class. Just to test it. Now, notice, even though I gave it the grow class, nothing happened. Why is that? Well, because even though we have the width as 30% here, and then the class should override that. It doesn't work like that in the hierarchy of CSS. Basically, it's going to ignore this because it's in the class, and since this is directly on the image, it's going to ignore it. So in order to force it to do that, we're going to say important, which is going to make it override whatever it had before, and go ahead and make it at 100%. So let's go ahead and rerun this. And as you can see, now it's at 100%, but all the other pictures are still there. So what we want to do is we want to make these all be zero. So we're going to go ahead and make this the width of 0%. Again, we're going to say important. Okay. And then I'll show you why I needed to write another line, but let's show you how this is going to work. So let's take this off of here, and we're going to do this dynamically as we click on whatever we need. Okay. So in order to do that, you're going to need jQuery. So we're going to go ahead and add jQuery to my project. But of course, you're going to use the CDN. Now that we have jQuery set up, we're going to just put the function here. Okay, now that it's initialized, we're going to just view a few lines. So what we're going to need is, here's the image gallery. Okay, here's the image gallery. So what we're going to say is, when we go to the image gallery and we click on an image, okay, so that all I'm saying is when I click on an image in the image gallery, we want this function to run. Okay, what do we want it to run? We want this, so whatever image, we want to toggle the class, and the class we're going to toggle is grow. So we're going to run that. It would help if I spelled this correctly. So now we run this. Okay, now we have run this. When we click on it, as you can see, it goes ahead and clicks. Now, obviously, if I click on more than one, it's going to just toggle and add the class to each one. So how do we make the rest of these go away? So in order to do that, we're going to say of all of the image gallery, but not the one I click on, we're going to toggle class, and we're going to say shrink. Okay, and of course, we've got to separate these lines. So we run this, and as you can see, it looks like everything is working fine. Now, it might seem that everything is working fine, but let me go ahead and do one more class here. Let's go to the image gallery, and we're going to say border green solid. And if you've seen any of my past videos on coding, you know that's what I like to do. I like to actually troubleshoot by just putting a border around things to make sure everything's working the way it's supposed to be working. So as you can see, everything is formatted correctly here. But when I click on this, as you can see, there's a little bit of a border here and a little less here. If I click on the last one, you see there's less and more. If I click on the first one, there's less and more. And that's because even though they're at 0%, they're basically still there because of the flex format. So what we're going to do is we're going to add one more thing here, and we're going to say display none. We're going to run this. And now what you'll see is when we click on this, we have nothing at the top or the bottom. You see? So it brings it all perfectly. So now we could erase this green solid here. Could run that. And now our format is going to be beautiful. And as you saw, this was, you know, obviously I like to expand my coding so that it's easy to read, but as you can see, it's just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 lines of code, and we were able to make this beautiful gallery. Now, this gallery works no matter how many are in the gallery. So let's go ahead and erase a few. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 of them. So let's run that. We have 6 photos, same thing. You see? So it doesn't really matter how many photos we have. Let's go ahead and make 4 photos. Let's do 4 photos. Let's go ahead and reset this to be 50%. Let's see, 40, just to make it. Now, the reason I'm doing 40 is because there's so much padding and margin and everything between the photos. It's going to actually overlap if I go to exactly 50%. So now when we click on it, we have 4 pictures here and they come right back. And it animates beautifully. So once again, I wanted to thank each and every one of my subscribers to bringing me to 5,000 subscribers. And I wanted to thank you all, subscriber or not, just you viewers, by giving you all of this code absolutely free. If you have any questions, please let me know. Have a wonderful day.